A very good noon to one and all. In the machine shops, normally surface plates are used as a diatom surfaces. So surface plates are mostly rectangular, and they are rectangular shape having 4:3 length to width ratio. So these plates are very rigid in design, and they are ribbed in the bottom surface, so that no warping takes place when heavy loads are placed on that. So the top surface of the plate is scraped to true flatness. A lot of care is taken during the manufacturing of these surface plates, particularly the machining of the top surface of the surface plate. So, and many times the straight edges are used to check the flatness of the surface plates. Now you can see here we have this straight edge, and we can always use a Prussian blue. So Prussian blue can be applied to this knife edge, okay, and then the straight edge is moved along the surface of the surface plate. Wherever there are top peak points, Prussian blue gets added to the top peaks, and then those peaks can be removed by scribing operations. So like this, we should scrap the surface so that it is made flat, very flat. And for big surface plates, leveling screws are provided for adjusting the top surface to truly horizontal. Now standard available sizes of plates are sizes vary from 100 by 100 millimeter to 2000 by 100 millimeter in 13 ranges. So all the four edges of the surface plates are finished straight and are square to each other, finished straight and square to each other. So according to the Indian standard, the surface plates are made by cast iron, and those are classified into two grades. So as a grade 1 and grade 2. So depending upon the requirement, if it is for inspection grade, for calibration grade, we should go for a grade 1. So if it is for measurement of flatness or straightness, we can go for the grade 2. And then surface plate is used to provide datum or a reference surface in most of the measurement activities carried out in the machine shops. Okay, now let us move on to the geometric feature straightness. So straightness of the component. So let us try to understand what is the meaning of straightness. So we can see here a line is said to be straight over a given length if all points on the line remain within the two lines drawn parallel to the general direction of the line in question, so separated by tolerance amount. So for example, this is a general direction of the line, and now on this line we have many points or maybe peaks and valleys are there. Now we have to draw two lines parallel to this general line, so which are separated by the tolerance amount. Say this tolerance amount is some 0.05 millimeter. If all the peaks and valleys on that particular line are well within this range, then we say that line is straight. Now straightness tolerance, it can be applied to an axis. Now when the tolerance, so straightness tolerance is applied to the surface, so at many places it is needed that work surfaces must be perfectly straight. For example, in the case of lathe, the tool must move in a straight path to generate a perfect cylinder. So this is possible only when the guide ways are straight, and the guide ways are straight, the carriage will move on this straight guide way, and then the cutting tool will give the cut on the work space, and then we get cylinders. So if the guideways are not straight and some error is there, then the tool will also move in this fashion, so that we do not get the proper cutting. So we get a lot of errors on the work pieces. So now in order to check whether the machine tool guideway is straight or not, we use many instruments and methods, so that we will study now. Now we should understand what is the meaning of straightness tolerance zone. We can see here we have a cylindrical object, and on this surface the straightness tolerance is given, it is 0.1 millimeter. So what is the meaning of this? Now we have this cylinder and we take one generator. So if you take one generator on this particular cylinder, so this variation should not exceed this 0.1 millimeter. So this is the straightness tolerance. So that means this gap is 0.1 millimeter. Like this, we have to consider many generators. So we have to make measurements on many generators, and in all the generators, if the error is within 0.1, then the cylinder is said to be straight. Okay. Similarly, on the flat surfaces, planar surfaces, again on the surface, the straightness tolerance is 0.01. That means on this surface, if you consider a line, okay, so all the variations in the vertical plane should be within this 0.01 millimeter. So if that is a case, we say this particular surface is straight. Now having understood what is the meaning of straightness and straightness tolerance, now we will move to the measurement of straightness. Now by using a straight edge, how to check the straightness? Now this straight edge is a rectangular or I-shaped device with a beveled edge. So it looks like this. So we have this rectangular shape, and then one end is beveled like this with a small radius at this place, and then the straightness of this particular edge is well within 1 micron depending upon the length. Now these are made generally using with steel or cast iron, and they are available in different lengths, like half meter length or 1 meter, 2 meter, 3 meter. Okay. For example, when you want to measure the straightness of machine tool guideways, so this is straight slide of the machine tool, and there is a machine bed wherein we have the guideways. And say we want to check whether the guideway is straight or not. So depending upon the size of the machine, this length of the guideway may be 0.5 meter, 1 meter, or 2 meter. So throughout the length, whether the guideway is straight or not, that we want to check. So in that case, we can use these straight edges, and the straight edges can be placed on the guideway, and then straightness can be checked. Now we can use directly the straight edge on the machine tool bed or guideway. We can check, or sometimes along with the surface plate, the straight edge can be used for the measurement of straightness. Now according to the Indian standard, so straight edges are provided in two grades. So grade A, so which are used for inspection purpose, and grade B for the workshop purpose. So by using Prussian blue and straight edge, the irregularities on the surface plate can be found, as I already explained. So in this photograph, which shows an I-shaped straight edge, so this is a finished scraped surface. So this surface is used for checking purpose, and different lengths are possible to reduce the weight. The holes are made here, and you can also see some ribbing to increase the rigidity of the straight edges. Okay. So now for checking the straightness of the components, the straight edge is placed along the full length of the surface, and the two are viewed against the bright light. Now you can see here, this is workpiece, and we want to measure whether this top surface is straight or not. So in that case, we have to take this straight edge and we have to keep it on the surface. On the other side, we should keep a light source, bright light source. And now, whether the light is passing between the straight surface plate, top surface plate, and the knife edged straight edge. Okay, we have to check whether the light is passing in between the surface plate, top surface plate, and knife edged surface edge, straight edge. So that we have to observe light passing in the gap, we should observe. So if no light is passing, then the workpiece surface is straight. If there is some light, it indicates that there is some error, straightness error. A quantitative assessment can be made by observing the color of the light. So due to interference caused by diffraction of light while passing through the gap, the color of light changes. If the color is red, it indicates a gap of 1 to 2 microns. And if the color is blue, the gap is 7 to 8 microns. So in this way, we can check the straightness of the workpieces. Okay, workpiece surfaces. Now, along with the straight edge, along with the slip gauge and the straight edge, we can check the straightness. So the procedure is like this. So we have to use a surface plate at datum surface, and then this is component, the straight edge of which it is to be checked. So this could be surface plate or a straight edge. Now here we have to keep the slip gauge. Say this is point number O, 0, and then so we have to mark, say, see, this is L. So we have to support this length at every points like this. We have to use another set of slip gauges and we have to support like this. So that this distance is airy distance, so that the blending is minimum. Now we have to divide this distance into 10 equal parts. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So now the height of this particular slip gauge is say 10 millimeter, and the height of this particular set is say 11 millimeter. So now we can we know the height of this point number 0 is 10 millimeter, and here it is 11 millimeter. The height is 11 millimeter and the point number 10, but the height is 11 millimeter. Okay, so the theoretical height at this point will be 10.1. And here it is 10.2 and 10.3, 10.4, and here it is 10.5. This is 10.6, 10.7, 10.8, 10.9, and 11. So this is a height is 11. So this is 10 and this is 11. So theoretical heights we know. Now we have to use slip gauges, and we have to insert the slip gauges at all these points, and actually what is the height we have to measure, and then we can draw the graph. So this is the portion on the workpiece surface. Say this is point number 0 and up to 10. At a point 0, the height is 10 millimeter. And at a point number, at this point, the height is 11 millimeter. So now we can join this by means of a straight line. Now actual distances, actual heights we have to measure by inserting slip gauges. Say this is 5. So at point number 1, say the height is 10.1, something like that. And here it is second point, third point, fourth point, fifth point, sixth, eighth, 9 and 10. This is 10th point. So if you join, then we get a line like this. Now we have to draw two lines, one passing through this peak and another one passing through this valley. So this gap gives us the straightness error of this particular edge. So this is a edge to be inspected. So what is the error in this particular edge can be obtained by this method. Now another method is by use of spirit level. So we can check the straightness of the component. Spirit level consists of a sealed glass tube and it is mounted in the base. The inside surface of the tube is ground to the convex barrel as shown here, and this radius is a large radius, and then there is a scale engraved on this on the glass, and the tube is filled with either alcohol, and then there is a small air bubble. So this air bubble is always tries to remain at the topmost point. So if the base is perfectly horizontal, then the bubble will be at a center of the scale. And if it is tilted, if the spirit level is tilted, then it tries to occupy the topmost point. It always try to remain at the highest point of the tube. These spirit levels, they are used for leveling the machine tools, and they are also used to check the straightness of the surfaces. Now the test procedure is like this. The test can be carried out by using spirit level or autocollimator. The procedure remains same. The straightness of any surface could be determined by either of these instruments by measuring the relative angular positions of number of adjacent sections made on the surface to be tested. So what we have to do is we have to draw a line on the surface whose straightness is to be inspected like this. So this is the surface to be inspected, and here we have to draw a straight line, and then we have divide this straight line into number of equal parts. And the distance between two adjacent lines being L. So this distance is L, where L is the distance between the base, the 2 feet on the spirit level. So this is a spirit level, and this is a glass tube with a bubble, and 2 feet will be provided on the autocollimator reflector surface or the spirit level. So this distance center distance is equal to the L. So by knowing this L, we can divide this line into equal number of parts, keeping the distance between two lines, which is equal to L. Now the spirit level can be used only for the measurement of straightness along horizontal surfaces, whereas autocollimators can be used to check the straightness on vertical and inclined surfaces also. So in case of spirit level, the block is moved along the line on the surface to be tested in the steps equal to the pitch distance between the center lines of the feet. The angular variations are measured by the sensitive level. So that means in the first place, in the first position, so what is the reading of spirit level, that should be noted down. And then it is moved to the second section again. So what is the bubble reading, that should be noted. So this bubble in the spirit level reading will change when the straightness changes. So angular variations can be correlated in terms of difference of height between the 2 points by knowing the least count of the level and length of the base. Now with this we will conclude this session. So in this session we learnt about the importance of geometric tolerancing and what are the terms associated with dimension feature measurement, and then we also learnt what are the various methods of measuring the straightness, and out of those methods we started the discussion on measurement of straightness by using the spirit level. So with this we will conclude in the next session. We will continue the discussion on straightness measurement by using various methods. Okay, thank you. So I hope everyone understand this. So read well, stay home, stay safe. Thank you. Bye.